Hey everybody, ChristopherOdd here. Welcome back. This is Operation Little King. We need to hack the Hidden Resistance computer. That's why we're bringing Parker. But we're bringing Baron, Calantro, and Massa Mooney as well. I'm going to replace her grenade, though, with a flashbang that I bought. I also ensured that our Davy McDragon, I think his name is, the engineer, is working in the Advanced Warfare Center now. So I think it was like 17 days to build. So, here we go. Operation Little King. Let's give it a shot. I love that Avenger. It's so cool. Or Sky Ranger, sorry. She corrects me sometimes. It's fine. We have a good relationship.
A hacker trying to impress the Resistance found a way into the Advent network through an access point near our AO. From the looks of it, she found something critical tied to the aliens' latest operation. Unfortunately, she only lived long enough to recover a fragment of the data. We're moving to secure the area, eliminate any alien forces nearby, and hack that terminal before they manage to lock it down. We need that data if we're going to stop their progress.
Okay, slums district called Spider Hill. Sounds like a nightmare. In Tijuana. Let's touch down.
S-15, this is Avenger. The access point we're after is just ahead. Move to secure the area. Expect hostile resistance.
Okay, so the nice thing about the little flyover is we sometimes get sneak peeks, which is pretty helpful. What isn't helpful is that we have this giant road here, and it seems like we kind of have to deal with it. We have a building on this side, actually, which seems like a good target to get to. Maybe one here too, actually. So, we're not gonna know more until we get in there. And I think just standing around up here isn't gonna be that helpful, so let's move everybody in.
Time to motor.
Will do.
Oh, we're gonna find something here. What is it?
Without the introduction of human.
Okay,
DNA,
we got vipers.
These creatures once operating under the guise of Ben Men now show their true form. A purely reptilian species.
No reason for them to hide. The aliens don't need an infiltration unit anymore.
Yeah, fair enough, Bradford. Fair enough. I'm hoping they don't come close enough where we're gonna be unable to move. Okay, no, we're good. So let's bring Parker up top now. We're gonna advance. Sometimes they might have access to that just one space on the inside lip there. So for now, we're just gonna take things slow. Seems okay.
That's affirmative.
Bring Calantro up. Bring up Massa Mooney. And then last but not least, the infamous Chewy Chupacabra Baron. I have to put a capital on that middle name. It's bugging the hell out of me. It's a quirk. It's a small piece of OCD that I can share with all of you. Okay, this is scary to do. And I'm not feeling confident that we should do it, but like we have to advance. I can't just sit here. If we're gonna get revealed, we're gonna get revealed. So
okay.
Okay, good. They don't have vision here. Oh, they're over here. Hello. Hello.
On the move.
Let's bring these guys down.
Moving.
On the move.
And we could bring Parker over. Do we want to engage from here, though? I don't know. We may want to get up here and have direct sight on the objective building. And one of the things I'm looking forward to trying, because I haven't had a chance, is how that, I believe it's Gotcha, the mod that gives you, like, the line of sight indicators for flanking and squad sight and all that kind of stuff. It should show us when we're close enough to hack, too, so that's cool. Look, I mean, we can't get up there from there. We can't get there from here because the civilians. We could try and, like, run all the way around. But I feel as if, like, that's a little bit disingenuous to the system. So here's what we're gonna do. There's three of them here. We've got grenade launchers, but Oh, we can't reach it. Oh, yeah, we can. No, we can. I like this. I'm liking the idea that we can use one grenade and have three overwatches. We have Calantro close enough where an overwatch will actually matter. Ninja, we've got a flashbang, but we're I think we just overwatch here. And we just go for it. Yeah, let's go for it. Let's overwatch everybody else. Actually, I want to make sure that that doesn't make her overwatch with the pistol, so we'll do it individually. The others are fine. And then let's toss a little aid protocol over on Ninja, just in case things go not according to plan. And then we're gonna toss this grenade down and get started. Other way, Chewie. Other way, please. God, we're gonna need monster shots here, preferably on the Viper. There we go. Come on, Chew. Nice. Nice. Oh, this thing is resilient.
I nicked him.
Oh, he dodged all of those. Holy shit, that is disgusting. Yeah, well, I mean, good job. But now we have two troopers down here who are probably going to come up here and flank the hell out of us. Oh, you've got defense. Who's he going on? Oh, Chewie. Thank God for armor.
We need emergency evac.
Seriously? Chewie. Chewie. Unacceptable. Fuck. He's not going on Chewie because of the armor. Oh my God, these guys. That is ridiculous. That sucks. All right, we have to unfuck ourselves right now. And that's not gonna be easy. One thing we can do is come down here and get a decent shot with Yuri. We can come down here and flank this guy. I'm thinking though that it might be better if we grab Let's actually bring Sean down. Let's go. Yeah, over here, pal.
That's how it's done.
That is how it's done. Great job. 83% to kill this guy with the pistol. Let's go for it. There we go.
You shit. Want some more?
Okay. We're gonna have to start carrying a med kit, I think.
Scanning.
Okay, he's no longer panicked. But he's also not in like the greatest position we've ever seen. So we have serious work to do. I wonder if we can use this. Okay, yeah, see, look, there's a little gear icon that shows us where we can hack this thing from. So that's actually immensely helpful. I wonder if we can get it from up here. No. Down here we can. And up here we can, actually. So that is looking pretty good all of a sudden. Okay, let's bring Parker in. Oh, shit. Yeah. Okay. That'll do it every time. It's not good. We're gonna have to pull him back. We have great chances on these guys, though. Do we go on the officer is the question. Do we go on, like, almost the guaranteed kill of the trooper, or just try and kill the officer outright? Chances are that we don't kill the officer. Actually, we have two really good shots at killing the officer. So maybe we do that. Yeah. I think so. Let's go, Cilantro. Just a little tap is fine. That seems like it was more than a tap, which is great. And then Chewy maybe is the one to do this, so we can grab full cover. Maybe. So I'm going to have to bring Sean back, right? And he's going to, he's not in a, like, I'm not stoked on his positions. I'll probably move him back, like, here. I'm not sure. If I don't take this shot with Masamune, then we have a 51% chance up top. But I'm thinking what we should do, if we move over here, we can flank the guy up top with Chewy, and then that's our shot. So if she can, in fact, hit this guy, that would be huge. Nice.
Check
very nice.
Before you get too close.
Okay, now I'll move Chewy in. I actually think, oh no, these guys aren't close enough, forget it. Let's go for the flank. Come on now. Yes. That sounds like a dead trooper to me.
There you go.
And then we can bring him back. If I tuck him in here, everybody's got vision on him regardless. If I bring him over here, it's one guy that has vision. So I think that's our better, move. Going inside is not preferable. Let's hide behind
absolutely
the tires. We've got two guys in half cover that are gonna be pretty good targets, I think. Oh, nice job. Nice
incoming
job just
fire
being cool. Whoa. Yeah, we can't do that while this is happening. Okay. That's smart for them. It's all fine and dandy, isn't it? Well, Cilantro? Come on now. Channel your inner Loxley. Yes, baby. That feels good. Feels good.
You can't handle me.
Now we've got shots here. They're just like, they're kind of terrible. This one's not bad. It's 50-50 to hit this guy. If we hit him, then we can move in and kill him. Nice. Or, hey, shit, Masamune is showing up for business. This is really good. We still have four turns. I'm not gonna move Sean in as much as I would like to.
We're going to go.
We're gonna be cool about this. We're gonna be cool about this. We need to reload up here on Cilantro. Reload
ready
back here.
Oh,
we
yeah
just need to get into a position to see that frickin' thing. We could even do that from in here, which is maybe the right idea. Or we go up top like we originally planned.
No
let's
need
do that.
To ask twice.
Double time. If you say so.
Affirmative. Objective position confirmed.
That's what I like to hear.
Commander, we have confirmation of the exposed access point.
That's what I like to hear. So we can actually grab this from this position as well, apparently. This is really cool. Like, I love having that. It's just like, because we should know the range of our gremlin and what it's capable of, and this answers that question.
Heading out.
Let's bring Parker in. And let's hack this bad boy.
Hacking in.
It also shows us our chance of hacking before we go in now, which is pretty helpful. This one, we're gonna hack regardless, it doesn't matter, but Okay, current region increased by 25 supplies. Not great. Delays the current dark event project by 2 weeks. Pretty good, but chances are low. We'll just take the one with the best chance. Doesn't matter anyways. I'm pretty sure we have the worst hacking success of all time. It's just not our thing. My goal is to make a super specialist.
Acquisition of the Advent files. Eliminate any remaining hostiles in the area.
Okay, we've got action over there somewhere. I think
Let's
we'll play it cool here. If the timer's done, I guess we can move up a bit.
I hope it's worth it.
On it.
Now we just need to hunt the rest down.
On our watch.
Enemy moving ahead.
Okay, let's take a little peek over here.
Not a problem.
Everything's
right,
cool.
I'll
We're just gonna follow in that path.
Tired of waiting around. I guess that'll be okay.
And we'll just move building to building and systematically clear these guys out.
Hostiles are moving.
Okay, now they're coming from this side.
Need to find some new cover.
Whoa, hello. Looks like they had the same idea. Oh, that was a nice shot, Mr. Parker. That was gorgeous.
Negative damage.
Oh. Followed up by absolutely nothing happening. Okay. Good news is these guys are all high ground. Which means a couple of things for us. So from this location, I just wonder, if I go here, can I get a grenade this far to knock both of those guys down? I'm not sure. Definitely not sure.
Let's move already.
We're gonna take the safer bet.
Here.
Put these guys through the floor. It'll kill one. That might kill both, actually. The fall may kill him. Yes. Okay, that is good. We've got Sean, who can come over here and flank, which is, you know, it's reasonable. It's reasonable. She has a shot from back here that's a flank as well. I like that. And then we can bring Chewie over, maybe take the shot down there, or maybe just blow him up. And then Parker, I'm not sure. We have the flashbang though, and maybe we should just look at the flashbangs are so good. Maybe I should be using that, you know? Let's
okay.
bring Masamune in this way. We can only hit, actually, we can hit both. We can hit both. And maybe that's the smarter play here. We see if we can kill them. If not, we hit both. What I don't like is the fact that if Sean gets hit, he is dead. So actually, I could bring him back here to flank too. That's a better position. It's far enough away.
Absolutely.
Let's do this. Okay, 87. Come on, Sean. Just not three and we're good. Oh, fuck. That's not good. Oh, that is not good. That opened things right up. And she's now standing out in the open. Fuck, Sean. Oh, my God. Okay, here's what we're doing. I believe, Chewie. Okay, this is fine.
One down, thousands to go.
We could take this shot, but you know what? We're just gonna flashbang this one remaining trooper. Apparently that's hitting him. Doesn't look like it's hitting him. There we go.
Better close your eyes.
We've got our sniper out in the open. He's disoriented. He's probably gonna do something stupid. I'm counting on it. Uh-oh. He's being brave. This little prick. I swear to God, if he pulls this off... Fuck! Oh my God! Fuck that guy. That sucks. The fact that he nailed that shot is devastating. I'm hoping that he's our last guy. And we're just gonna blow this place apart. And we'll give her the revenge kill, hopefully. Yeah. How are you feeling now? Feeling great? We're just gonna use our little tiny pistol against you, punk. I don't know why I'm so, like, vehemently against this trooper.
You see that?
Status
I did.
Confirmed. All hostiles are down.
That was quick.
And the area is secure. Status confirmed. Mission accomplished.
That was quick. We took a lot of frickin' heat, though. I feel like we could have been way more efficient. But, regardless, not bad. Palantro, look at all the damage she dished out. That's crazy. And then, Sean, just trying to keep things interesting at the end there by blowing out her cover so she can just stand there in the open. Oh, man. And that guy's aim was probably... I should have checked, actually. I should have checked what his aim was with being disoriented. She had no cover, though. So... It was probably still... He probably still had, like, a 30 or 40% chance to hit us, which he did. Which feels great. Assuming these guys are almost dead. Yeah, 43 days. Fuck. Sorry for just dropping F-bombs here, but I'm frustrated as hell with that. Okay, Sean. Seeing as how you're blowing out your allies' cover, I feel like your penance is to become a battle medic. And that'll give us some extra first aid charges, so it's not bad. I mean, he's not going to be back for a while. We do have another promotion here. This is good. We'll grab Long Watch. And Masamune. Grenadier. Hey, I'll take that. We're training a Grenadier as well, so that's actually really good. 9 days of fatigue. 10 days wounded. I mean, it's all relevant. There was an Illyrian core on the ground that we didn't pick up, but it was still available at the end.
Hello,
Viper autopsies.
Commander.
Intel, alien cipher countered. Okay, I mean, I don't like it, but like, Jesus, look at all these injuries. Crazy. We are going to have Edwards and Biscamp back right away. We have Easterbrook. We got options. We got to keep taking out rookies too. So it's not... I'm just basically talking to myself here, but... Trying to convince myself that things aren't so bad. Nice, the black market. That could be big. The rookies, I don't think we like... need them. So I think we're gonna bypass that for now. Black market, do we want that? Do we want to be spending some of our intel? Maybe. Should we focus on making contact here first? It opens up more guerrilla ops missions, and then gets us access to the black site, which we will probably take sooner rather than later. So, I'm just not sure which we should prioritize. What are the dark events that we know of? Rapid response. think we'll go black market.
New course.
We could get some weapon upgrades. I wouldn't buy a soldier for intel at this point. But let's see what's there.
Market is open.
All right. So, speed's not bad. I actually would consider rushing one of these for the intel cost. I know it's pricey, but that could be, like, really beneficial. We are going on mag weapons right now, are we not? Yeah, we went mag weapons. We could knock that down to 9 days. 9 days. That's pretty good. The challenge is that we don't have the supplies to fund those weapons yet. We could sell a bunch of corpses. We could sell, let's see what they're buying right now. Like, we have actually, because of that resistance haven, we actually have a ton of money sitting here. But do we also need... Let's see. We could buy alloys with intel as well. So we got that covered. So maybe we could do it. Let's do this. I feel like we're gonna... They're offering a lot right now. They're very interested in these things. I don't know what this exclamation point is. Oh! Yes, I do. This is a mod, which is fucking awesome. Okay? So this mod, how it works, is it shows you... the things that you have, what they can be used for when you're hovering over this, so you don't sell things that you don't want, like, accidentally. And you can configure it. I haven't done so. This is just the standard version. But, like, these Advent Trooper corpses are used for nanoscale vests. I'm probably not going to buy any of those, so I could sell a bunch of these. But there's another version of this mod, if you tweak it, where it'll show you upcoming research that these could be good for. And, I may do that too, because actually that's very, very helpful. Instead of like referring to the tech tree and then going to figure it out. If we were playing for like the very first time, obviously I wouldn't have any of these mods on, and then it's kind of like you're learning as you go. But yeah. We're going to get a nice little surge from these trooper corpses early, which is pretty cool, I guess. It's worth the hassle of the resistance haven.
Market is open.
Did we not? Yeah, we did that. I feel like our mag weapons didn't increase by as much as I was anticipating.
Market is open.
It halves the remaining research time. Didn't we say it was going down to like 9 days? Maybe I did something weird there.
Setting course for the Eastern
okay, that's
US
strange.
Precinct.
Oh well. 14's still pretty good, I guess. I just feel like we might have wasted a bit. Okay, so we have another grenadier. This is very nice. Let's carry on. Let's throw somebody else into the guerrilla tactics school. I feel like we're gonna get so much use out of this guerrilla tactics now. Who do we want our next soldier to be? I feel like there's no real reason to bring out rookies if we don't have to, if we can just get them all trained in there. Crazy Dude had a new biography because he had like so much potential, right? But his biography, I believe, is just, it's blank. Okay, so here is his bio. Born and raised in East, let's actually go in here. Born and raised in East Northport, Long Island, he was just a small child when the alien invasion happened and the program known as XCOM was activated and decimated in almost a month. After the major loss for the people of Earth, they decided to sign a treaty of peace with the aliens and made the Advent Coalition. He was only 7 when the Advent Coalition moved into his town and set up their outpost there. He wanted to be just like them. There's more to it. It's in a comment of previous videos. I would suggest you go and read it, but it won't all fit in here. So I thought that was a good little cliffhanger to end it on. But Joseph Crazy Dude Zach, thank you for the updates. You also did give me... his age and the like, did you not? I don't think that really matters. We're not gonna pump that into your bio I think that's okay. This is good. Joseph Crazy Dude Zach, welcome to the squad. I'm gonna send you in for some training, I think. And what do we want this training to be? I'm thinking a couple of specialists is not a bad idea. That was him, right? It's Joseph Crazy Dude. Yeah, Joseph Crazy Dude. What kind of training do we want? Some people were suggesting I should look at the infantry class mod as well, that's apparently really well done. So I may do that. I think a specialist would be good. We only have the one right now. And we have a couple of grenadiers, a couple of snipers, a ranger, and we have a couple of the new classes, so yeah, I think it's good. Now these, I don't know why they all start in blue, but that's a real tease. We could grab Vulture right now if we wanted to get additional items. That could actually help us load out all these weapons. And if we grab it early, we get the most benefits from it, right? As far as I'm concerned. Hello. This could help us as well. Operation Swamp Storm. Raid the Advent Train, baby. Let's go. One thing I should consider doing is, since we know exactly when this is going to expire, like, I should squeeze some of that time out. It's risky because, like, one misclick and it's like, you're screwed. So, I don't know if I should get to that level of micromanagement, but... Okay, let's bring out Biscamp for sure. Let's bring out Voper. And then I think a couple of squaddies is good. We could bring out our Ranger in Easterbrook. And maybe another Grenadier, our new Grenadier in Borges. That could be fine. The only challenge is that next mission, we're only gonna have Masamune available. And probably Chewy Chupacabra, which is two Grenadiers, which is fine. But is that a risk that we should take? Is that cutting us a little bit thin? We have Angmar. Oops. So yeah, if we do this, we would have Angmar, Chewy, Masamune, and then I guess we would take out a rookie. Maybe we should take a rookie out now. Because what's the next type of mission that we might run into? Probably a council mission. VIP, probably. A rescue. Or an escort. So maybe a rookie's not bad, because we can make the argument that the rookie could carry the VIP if that's the case. Or maybe it's one where we just escort them. I don't know. So who knows? Either way. Let's do this. Let's take out a random rookie here. Let's take out Mitch Nichols. He's been waiting patiently, hasn't he? There is a mod where I can strip weapons as well. And that might be something to look into. We're just going to make sure that she gets her weapon color back. I think hers was yellow, because we were using her gun for training day, I believe. But let's get this going again. I actually really like that vine leaf. Hexacamo is nice. Let's do Iranian Atomic Organization. That's cool. She just looks bitter. B as F. I like that. Make utility items available. Who did we have training day on in that last mission? I think it was Masamune, which means she's actually not even holding it anymore. It's fine. There it is. And And I don't think we have any upgrades available right now, do we? No, we don't. Okay, cool. So I think this is going to be our squad. Biscamp, our trooper, and he's going to be carrying a shotgun. So I like this idea. He can shoot and have the shotgun if he wants. He's got the ability to mark targets, so plus 15 aim for two turns. Don't know what the cooldown is. Don't know if it's single use. The only way to find out is to try it. Let's change your weapon color up a bit. Let's go into the reds. And you can change the pattern up a slightly. I mean, you are German, so maybe we should go with, like, a German pattern. I actually like this Strickmuster. It's pretty cool. Okay, we're all set. Biscamp, Edwards, Easterbrook, Nichols. Raid the train. Moderate difficulty. That's our first moderate, which means we're in shit, probably. We don't have a grenadier. Sucks, big time. But we will take the flashbang. So yeah. Wish me luck, guys. We'll see you soon. And take care of yourselves. Bye.
The world you once knew is no more. Earth is now ruled by the Advent Coalition and their alien masters.